Let me show you the most powerful WordPress auto spinner that's available as of now. It can spin content that you scrape or the content that you have already. And I'll show you why this is the best plugin right now. The spinner that I'm talking about is called Auto Spinner, and right now it's on sale for $18. Again, this is just for a limited time, so most of the time you'll get it for $27. So hurry up and check that link in the description. Right now, I have connected with OpenAI. And why is that? Because first of all, we can use Auto Spinner the traditional way. It can use synonyms to change certain words of the topic that we're going to add, the post. But if we use OpenAI GPT, it can rephrase the phrase or the whole content and even make a whole different content based on that content that we're going to add. So it makes it really powerful. Now, reasons why you want to spin content is because let's just say that you're an Amazon affiliate and eBay, etc. You don't want to post the content as it is when you scrape it because, well, Google is not gonna rank it. But if we spin it and if we do it with AI, well, we can make it really interesting and it's gonna rank it for us. Those are some of the reasons. You can have other reasons for spinning. That's up to you, okay? Now, there's two ways that we can spin. One is doing it manually, so I'll add a new post, or we can do this automatically, which is my favorite part. You can start scraping and it'll automatically spin the content. So we can go ahead and add a title. For this, I am gonna grab this post right here from Amazon because I'm an Amazon affiliate. So I'll add the post here and I'll add some information. Here it is. Okay, I'll add all of this. I'll grab this data, post it here, and I'll keep it simple with that data. Okay, so this is the information. Now on the bottom, we're gonna get this option, WordPress Auto Spinner. That's a plugin installed. So I'm gonna rewrite this post. Like I mentioned before, we can do it manually, individually here on the post, or we can have it set and forget and do it automatically with the settings, which I'll show you in a bit. Here we go. The article has been rewritten. And here it is, the title has been rewritten and the content. This is not the same content from up here, okay? It's been rewritten. So here we go, 20% larger battery. On the bottom, it should say something about battery, but not the same. So it's gonna spin that content. Now go ahead and pause it and check it out for yourself. But this has been spinned with this information, okay? Now, the amount of rephrasing, et cetera, we can change that if we're using OpenAI like I am. So let me show you. Let me go ahead and leave. That's one of the ways you could do it manually, but all the settings are here in the plugin. So go into settings and you have the option here. Let me go down here. The most important part, here it is, the spinning method. So in the spinning method, you have the option to use the inbuilt system database. That means it's gonna spin content based on synonyms. So it's gonna change a couple of words in the content, which is not super good because Google will detect these kind of things. But if you use something like OpenAI or WordAI API, then this is gonna spin content really good that even Google's not gonna know that it's the same piece of content. With OpenAI, we have several options available that make it really interesting. So for example, let me show you. With OpenAI, we add the key to our OpenAI, and then we have the option to tell it what we want to do with it. So in this case, it's telling it to rephrase and don't touch the HTML. Why is that? Because if we are automatically scraping content, it will scrape it with the whole HTML, and we wanna keep that sometimes. So it'll only rephrase the words inside of the content, but not the HTML, so it's intact. Now, we can go super in depth into here, like saying, you know what, rephrase the content, but make it interesting, make it engaging, make it professional, make it even a 12-year-old can read it. And you can go in depth into all this information so it knows how GPT is going to work with the AI. So things can get really interesting and unique by using this system. You can even tell it to create H1, H2, H3 for SEO purposes and all that with this system. That's what I really like about it, because you can set and forget this, especially if you are an affiliate. Now there's a bunch of settings available that makes it really interesting. So for example, if you want to auto spin content, you tick this on. Do you want to spin the title? Yes. Sometimes you don't want to spin the title. Sometimes you do. And sometimes you don't want to spin the content, but sometimes you do. So you have the option to tick these on or off. You can spin the slug also. So you can spin it here, spin the link anchor text, spin manual post, spin instantly, yes, but on publish. So if it's scraping, it'll automatically do it. And you have a bunch of settings. Other important settings would be these, custom post types. So what do you want to spin? Only posts, or do you want to spin pages, other categories, WP blog, embed, etc. In most of the cases, you just want to spin the post, not the pages. And we also have the options to change the cron, but you have the options to select what you want to spin in categories also. So in my case, I have categories for video and WordPress and uncategorized. So maybe I just want to spin content for WordPress and don't touch videos. So sometimes on some of my pages, I'll scrape the videos that I make. So I post them on my page automatically. But I like what I wrote on the video, so I don't want to spin that content. So I'll exclude that from the spinning, okay? And then you have exclude title words, exclude capital in post content. So for example, you want to exclude words that have a capital letter in the beginning because that might be a brand. So a brand could be something like spaces, and you don't want to spin that word, but since it has a capital letter, we know it's a brand and it's going to skip it. And there's other words that we can add here if we want to exclude. So words that we might know that we don't want to spin, for example, webhooks, Zapier, brands that you might know, your own name. For example, I'll add here SaaS Master. You don't want to spin that because SaaS is a word and master is a word also. So we don't want to detect it as a spinning system. So we'll add it here as a reserved word, or don't spin words that are inside of quotes because that might be important, or someone that it's saying something. So we have a ton of options for this. And there's also the thesaurus if you want to add more information here. But this is my favorite WordPress auto spinner because I can do it automatically, especially since I'm an affiliate. I'm not doing anything wrong because I have the, I would say, the right to pull in the content and spin it because I'm promoting their own content. So it's a win-win situation. But I don't want to get flagged by Google for spinning, well, not for spinning, for copying the content. That's why it's great to spin it, because that way I can also rank for that content. But there you go. That is the WordPress Auto Spinner. Do check out the link in the description. And if you're lucky, you'll get it on sale. Well, that's a wrap.